President Marcos orders continuous surveillance of Mpox. In a meeting with his health secretary, Ted Herbosa, Marcos said people most vulnerable to the disease, the immunocompromised, must be constantly monitored. Secretary Herbosa said all patients of Mpox have recovered, including the newest case detected this month. He also allayed fears the Mpox outbreak in Africa could be the start of a new pandemic.
Ang malinaw kasi sa atin is COVID eh. Kaya people are thinking, naku, parang COVID, magka-quarantine si Herbosa, mag-border control. This is actually more similar to HIV, which when it came out in 1983. Sa Philippines, wala pa tayong recorded case of death. Ang recorded case of death ay doon sa Africa na thousands yung cases. It's a good time to warn people na mag-ingat tayo how this virus spreads.
Corporate stories, Meralco sets to October 1st the deadline of the 1,000 megawatt bidding for its power supply requirements. It's a new schedule that follows a Taguig court's dismissal of a petition that sought to prevent the conduct of the competitive selection process. The Malampaya Consortium, led by Tycoon Enrique Razon's Prime Energy, filed a petition as it warned the bidding could put indigenous natural gas at a disadvantage. Meanwhile, there's a new CFO at Chelsea Logistics. It named Darlene Binay to the post beginning next month. Chelsea's webpage indicated Ms. Binay had been the company's finance controller prior to the appointment. She succeeds Ignacia Braga, who was listed as Chelsea's VP for finance. And finally, the C family's Dominion Holdings back in trading after the stock market lifted its suspension. DHI shares trade was halted in early 2020 after the Philippine Stock Exchange deemed BDO's sale of a controlling stake in the company as a backdoor listing. That agreement was ultimately terminated a year after. Former President Barack Obama and wife Michelle take the stage on day two of the Democratic National Convention. Michelle Obama urged Americans to vote for Kamala Harris and Tim Walz, saying hope is making a comeback. The former first couple also took digs at Donald Trump.
Here's a 78-year-old billionaire who has not stopped whining about his problems since he rode down his golden escalator 9 years ago. It has been a constant stream of gripes and grievances that's actually been getting worse now that he's afraid of losing to Kamala. We do not need four more years of bluster and bumbling and chaos. America's ready for a new chapter. America's ready for a better story. We are ready for a President Kamala Harris.
Of the two major candidates in this race, only Kamala Harris truly understands the unseen labor and unwavering commitment that has always made America great. Now, unfortunately, we know what comes next. We know folks are going to do everything they can to distort her truth.
Second gentleman Doug Emhoff, Vice President Harris's husband, also took the stage. He said his wife rises to the occasion whenever she's needed, despite her busy work schedule.
America, in this election, you have to decide who to trust with your family's future. I trusted Kamala with our family's future. It was the best decision I ever made.
The Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange preparing for the influx of travelers for the upcoming long holiday weekend. PITX officials expect around 1.5 million passengers to pass through the terminal from August 19 to 27. August 23, which is this coming Friday, and 26 next Monday are holidays, marking Ninoy Aquino Day and National Heroes Day. Meanwhile, the Metro Manila Development Authority says the number coding scheme will be suspended on both those days.